Hello people, I'm Dom the Big D, and today the D stands for... Disco Dancer! Alright, this one was very obvious. Just roll the intro. Alright, Disco Elysium. I'll begin the review with a disclaimer. Nearly everything in the game is a spoiler, so... if you are already curious about the game and are watching this review to make up your mind if it's worth a shot or not, close this video now and buy the game. I'm serious. It's the best game I've played in years and it's best experienced completely blind. Well, not literally, but you know what I mean. Okay, even having gotten rid of some people, I'll still try to keep spoilers to a minimum. Because Disco Elysium is a completely story-based game. It will be tricky though. I myself only read an article and saw some screenshots of the game about a year or two ago before playing it. I haven't seen any trailers, gameplay or anything like that, so I went in pretty much blind. I really liked the art style and the idea of an RPG where you play as a detective, but I had no idea what the game would be like. I guess I expected something similar to Shadowrun, but I was very pleasantly surprised right from the first seconds of the game.
There is nothing. Only warm primordial blackness. Your conscience ferments in it. No larger than a single grain of malt. You don't have to do anything anymore. Ever. Never, ever, baby.
Disco Elysium starts with a dream sequence, which is narrated by one of the most captivating voices I've heard in my life. I loved it. The intro also sets up a very supernatural feel, which is great. The player wakes up, only to realize the main character is a man with absolutely no memory, and on top of that, he keeps hearing dozens of different voices in his head that are more or less his organs and emotions that achieved sentience. That, or he went completely mad, which is very likely too. It's hard to tell when you have absolutely no memory of the world or yourself. How the memory loss happened is a mystery too, but it involved a lot of alcohol, and this is where the actual game begins. The protagonist is just as clueless about the surroundings as the player, if not more. And whatever you do, you are guided by these voices in your head. They are all great. Each of them is a complete character. Aside from that, they are also your skills. You can make some of these voices louder and some senses sharper. There are some fairly ordinary options like rhetoric or authority that are mostly used for speech checks, but it was the more unique skills that I liked the most. For example, my favorite one is called Inland Empire, which is hard to describe. It allows the player to be guided by dreams, sort of like Agent Cooper from Twin Peaks. No wonder this skill is a David Lynch movie reference. The reason I like this skill is that it keeps the supernatural spice in the game even after you start learning what is what and become used to your surroundings. That being said, all of these skills are equally good and everyone seems to have different favorites. The best part is that you won't be able to upgrade all of them. So every playthrough is very different and personal. I could see that the main mechanic of the game is being a person, and it's up to you to decide what person you'll be, since you have no past and probably no future. You can be a drug abusing communist.
Героин, марихуана, крэк. Наркотики откуда?
От верблюда.
Все ясно. Где я?
A sweet-talking bookworm? Why did I even write this as an example? It's not interesting. Or a superstar cop slash fashion police like me? In any case, you will likely be a dumpster-diving hobo too, but I'm 100% into that. In video games at least. To make the experience even more customized, in every playthrough the game also has a thought mechanic. You can internalize a limited number of thoughts that can improve some of your skills, make some of them worse, and most importantly they can even unlock new side stories and dialogue options. The thing that really surprised me is that however you decide to play, all of the choices fit the protagonist really well. I never felt like some of my choices were out of character, which I couldn't see about most games. And all of that is bound together by a sense of quirkiness and childlike curiosity about the world. The character is a blank sheet and the player is not familiar with the fictional world either, so it is really fitting to just stumble around everywhere and just explore. You're a detective after all, that's your job. And however I might dislike protagonists with amnesia in games, in Disco Elysium it really fits. Hell, it's an essential part of the plot. And about the world, the whole amnesia thing wouldn't really work if Disco Elysium depicted our world. Instead it takes place in a completely fictional universe. It is hard to tell what time period it is. Judging from the clothing, it could be 70s or 80s, but there is also some futuristic looking tech, so that's an interesting blend. The world also has a well-built historical and political background that the player must learn from scratch, just like the protagonist. Of course, a lot of parallels could be drawn to our world, but keeping everything fictional helps the game avoid prejudice from the player's side. The whole gameplay loop consists of just exploring and talking to people. And looting random pieces of clothing that alter your stats from random houses and trash, of course. And it's really pleasant, to be honest, due to brilliant writing. I usually hate reading in games, but here I was curious about every little remark. The game covers a lot of really serious topics very well, but at the same time, it made me laugh out loud fairly often, and knowing how apathetic I can be, that's quite a feat. By the way, I have mentioned that I imagined this game would be similar to Shadowrun, so I was real surprised to see that there is essentially no combat. It felt closer to L's Heartbreak, if anything, and to be completely honest, that was a great choice because it not only left more resources for developing a better story and world, it makes the game a lot more approachable for people who aren't really into games and can be put off by the difficulty of combat. It does add a lot of realism too. You don't see ordinary policemen going around just shooting people in reality. Or at least you shouldn't. Although I really liked the dialogues, exploration, character building, and found the overall story very immersive and addicting, not everything was perfect. One of the main things that I didn't like completely was pacing. Everything is great while you have a lot of leads to check out and areas to explore, but after you do most tasks you may start running out of things to do to advance the plot. I certainly went back and forth the entire map just looking for any items or dialogue choices I missed. As far as items go, it's nowhere nearly as bad as in old school adventure games, since Disco Elysium has plenty of ways to do everything. Sometimes failing to do things can lead to more interesting outcomes than succeeding. But dialogues, even though they are the best part of the game, managed to annoy me a bit. I don't always want to pick every dialogue option, especially since some of them may not lead to the best results, but there were cases when the option that I deliberately avoided was the one that advances the quest. Also, throughout the game there are plenty of skill checks, and I generally didn't mind failing them, since that can be interesting too, and in a lot of cases you can retry them later, but near the ending some of them made me compelled to save scum. You see, if you want to retry a skill check, you have to either level up the corresponding skill, or learn something new related to that skill check. And you can't really do either of those things if you exhausted all of the options already. There's this one particular part in the game that needs you to succeed in a single skill check and doesn't have an alternative way to advance the quest. So you'll likely not have a great time if you decided not to improve that skill like me. If you played the game, you definitely know which part I'm talking about. Aside from that one annoying dice roll, it makes a lot of sense to end up in the same place no matter how you went around the whole investigation, because after all, there's only one way the crime you're investigating actually happened. In most games I wouldn't be happy about choices leading you to the same place, but here it works. And since different choices and playstyles make the player go through fairly different content, I'm generally curious to play the game again right after finishing it to see all the things I missed. While I want to do a playthrough where I pump my Inland Empire skill to the max and become the ultimate psychic goofball, I'm curious about completely different playstyles too. And know what? Replaying the game wouldn't even be bothersome because the entire presentation of it is just as good as its writing. The visuals really do stand out. Everything looks like a painting, literally. I often see similar visual style in video game concept arts, but not in actual games. The textures in the game look like they've been roughly painted with a brush, and I can hardly tell what is just a two-dimensional piece of art and what is a full 3D model. The character models are shaded very well, so they fit in the painting-like environment perfectly. I think it's actually the first time I couldn't tell 2D and 3D graphics apart. Usually 3D animations or games that are stylized to imitate 2D just look wrong, but not Disco Elysium. The sound of the game is great too. I've already mentioned that the voice acting is great, even though there is not much of it.
What is this, a joke to you? Is this what you get when you call the police now? This guy?
The soundtrack is good too. I don't think I would go out of my way to listen to it on its own, but it's very memorable and fits the game perfectly. My only complaint is that you cannot change songs on this red boombox that you can just carry around on your shoulder like a complete chad. I wanted even more disco in my Elysium. So yeah, it may have some tiny imperfections, but I can see that Disco Elysium is my game of the year. I really thought that it would be past Logic 2, but there's only one third of that game released so far, so maybe next time I speak Lodge. Disco Elysium succeeded in every aspect for me to be something I could rate 10 out of 10, if I did use numerical rating system. It looks and sounds appealing, the story is one of the best I've experienced, and it has plenty of replay value. That's all and even more that I could want. And of course, for the end of the video, I've got an album that fits the game, just like always. And for Disco Elysium, I picked Wanderer by El Huervo. I know that a version of the album was already used as the soundtrack for El's Heartbreak, which I've already mentioned, but if I ever reviewed that game, I would pick something different, so I see we're fine. Wanderer is equally funky and mysterious, just like Disco Elysium. It has futuristic motifs, but they all go through this warm, rustic filter, and I think it makes for perfect atmosphere that is very similar to what Disco Elysium is going for. So yeah, it's a great game, thank you for watching my video, go play Disco Elysium yourselves, and see you next time. Bye bye.